Farxiga, a comprehensive guide for patients and caregivers. Are you looking for clear, reliable information about Farxiga? This video breaks down everything you need to know, from its uses and benefits to potential side effects and important precautions. Farxiga, also known as dapagliflozin, is an oral medication prescribed to improve outcomes in individuals with diabetes, heart disease, or kidney disease. It's a powerful tool in managing these conditions. Specifically, Farxiga is used to improve blood sugar control in adults and children, 10 plus, with type 2 diabetes, alongside diet and exercise. It also lowers the risk of hospitalization for heart failure in adults with type 2 diabetes who have cardiovascular disease or multiple risk factors. Farxiga reduces the risk of cardiovascular death, heart failure hospitalization, and urgent heart failure visits in adults with heart failure. Furthermore, it lowers the risk of worsening kidney disease, end-stage kidney disease, cardiovascular death, and heart failure hospitalization in adults with chronic kidney disease at risk of progression. Farxiga works by preventing glucose reabsorption in the kidneys, increasing glucose excretion in the urine. It inhibits sodium glucose cotransporter 2, SGLT2, found in the proximal renal tubules, which reabsorbs filtered glucose. By inhibiting SGLT2, Farxiga promotes glucose excretion in the urine. It also reduces sodium reabsorption, increasing the amount reaching the distal tubule. This influences physiological functions, lowering heart preload and afterload, downregulating sympathetic activity, and decreasing kidney pressure. Farxiga received FDA approval on January 8, 2014. Currently, there is no generic version of Farxiga available. Like all medications, Farxiga can cause side effects. It's important to be aware of these and discuss any concerns with your doctor. The most common side effects include female genital yeast infections, vaginal thrush, urinary tract infections, and nasopharyngitis, runny or stuffy nose. These are generally mild and treatable. However, Farxiga can also cause serious side effects. Diabetic ketoacidosis, DKA, is a major concern, especially for those with type 1 diabetes. DKA is a life-threatening condition requiring immediate hospitalization. Dehydration is another potential serious side effect. Farxiga can cause the loss of body water and salt, leading to dizziness, fainting, and lightheadedness, especially when standing up. Sudden kidney injury has also been reported. Vaginal yeast infections are common in women taking Farxiga. Symptoms include vaginal odor, white or yellowish discharge, and vaginal itching. Men may experience yeast infections of the penis, balanitis, with symptoms like redness, itching, swelling, and foul-smelling discharge. Allergic reactions are possible. Do not take Farxiga if you have a history of serious hypersensitivity reactions to dapagliflozin or any inactive ingredients. Anaphylaxis and angioedema have been reported. Farxiga should not be used in patients with type 1 diabetes to improve blood sugar control due to the increased risk of DKA. It's also not recommended for improving blood sugar control in people with type 2 diabetes with moderate to severe kidney disease. Dosages of insulin or other medications that increase insulin release may need reducing to avoid hypoglycemia. Farxiga may increase the risk of hypoglycemia when combined with these medications. Serious, life-threatening cases of necrotizing fasciitis of the perineum, Fournier's gangrene, have been reported. If you develop pain, tenderness, redness, or swelling in your genital or perineal area, along with fever or malaise, seek immediate medical attention. Some side effects may be more likely to occur in older adults. This is not a complete list of side effects. Always consult your doctor for medical advice about side effects. You can also report side effects to the FDA. Before starting Farxiga, it's crucial to discuss your medical history and current health status with your doctor. Certain conditions may make Farxiga unsafe for you. You should not use Farxiga if you are allergic to dapagliflozin, have severe kidney disease, or are on dialysis, or have diabetic ketoacidosis. Tell your doctor if you have type 1 diabetes or have had diabetic ketoacidosis. Also, inform them if you have polycystic kidney disease, a decrease in your insulin dose, or a serious infection. A history of vaginal or penis infections, liver problems, urinary tract infections, or problems with urination should be disclosed. If you are on a low-sodium diet, your healthcare provider may ask you to change your diet. If you are going to have surgery, your healthcare provider may stop your Farxiga before the procedure. Discuss when to stop and restart Farxiga with your doctor. Inform your doctor if you are eating less or there is a change in your diet, if you are dehydrated, or if you have or have had problems with your pancreas, including pancreatitis or surgery on your pancreas. Drinking alcohol very often or drinking a lot of alcohol in the short term, binge drinking, should be discussed. Also, inform your doctor if you are pregnant or plan to become pregnant, or if you are breastfeeding or plan to breastfeed. Farxiga may cause harm to an unborn baby, especially the developing kidneys. If you become pregnant while taking Farxiga, your healthcare provider may switch you to a different medicine to control your blood sugar. It is not known if Farxiga passes into your breast milk. You should not breastfeed if you take Farxiga. Always take Farxiga exactly as your doctor prescribed. Follow all directions on your prescription label and read all medication guides or instruction sheets. Your doctor may occasionally change your dose. Farxiga is taken one time per day, with or without food. Your treatment may include dietary changes, exercise, weight control, and special medical care. Your blood sugar will need to be checked often, and you may also need to test the level of ketones in your urine. Farxiga can cause life-threatening ketoacidosis. Even if your blood sugar is normal, contact your doctor if a urine test shows that you have high ketones in the urine. During prolonged illness, you may become dehydrated. Call your doctor if you are sick with vomiting or diarrhea or if you eat or drink less than usual. For adults and children aged 10 and older with type 2 diabetes, the initial dose is 5 mg once daily. It may be increased to 10 mg orally once a day for additional glycemic control if a lower dose has been tolerated. The maximum dose is 10 mg per day. For heart failure and kidney disease, the initial and maintenance dose is 10 mg orally once a day, with a maximum dose of 10 mg per day. The Farxiga package insert recommends withholding Farxiga for at least 3 days, if possible, before major surgery or procedures associated with prolonged fasting. Farxiga should be restarted once the person is clinically stable and has started eating or receiving nutrition again. If you miss a dose, take it as soon as you can, but skip the missed dose if it is almost time for your next dose. Do not take 2 doses at one time. If you overdose, seek emergency medical attention or call the poison helpline. Avoid drinking alcohol while taking Farxiga. Also, avoid getting up too fast from a sitting or lying position, or you may feel dizzy. Other drugs may increase or decrease the effects of Farxiga on lowering your blood sugar. Tell your doctor about all your current medicines and any you start or stop using, especially insulin, other oral diabetes medicines, diuretics, and lithium. Farxiga will increase urinary glucose excretion and will lead to positive urine glucose tests. Use alternative ways to monitor glycemic control. It also interferes with some other laboratory assays. This list is not complete. Other drugs may interact with dapagliflozin, including prescription and over-the-counter medicines, vitamins, and herbal products. Not all possible drug interactions are listed here. Always consult your doctor or pharmacist to check for potential interactions. Store Farxiga at room temperature away from moisture and heat. The active ingredient is dapagliflozin. Inactive ingredients include microcrystalline cellulose, anhydrous lactose, crospovidone, silicon dioxide, and magnesium stearate. The film coating contains polyvinyl alcohol, titanium dioxide, polyethylene glycol, talc, and yellow iron oxide. Farxiga is available as 5 mg and 10 mg tablets. It is manufactured by AstraZeneca Pharmaceuticals LP. Does Farxiga cause weight loss? Farxiga may lead to modest weight loss, even though it's not a weight loss drug. How long does it take for Farxiga to work? It starts working after just one dose, but it may take a week for Farxiga to take full effect. Can Farxiga cause kidney damage? It may cause acute kidney injury. Watch out for urinating less or swelling in your legs or feet. What is Farxiga used for and how does it work? It is used to treat certain adults with type 2 diabetes mellitus, heart failure, and chronic kidney disease. It works by inhibiting SGLT2 and reducing the activity of the sympathetic nervous system. Can Farxiga cause constipation? It may lead to constipation in some people, but it doesn't seem to happen often.